In that news break, we reported how two different preliminary inquiries have quoted from emails written by Mr. Vadra and his executive assistant Manoj Arora to associates of Sanjay Bhandari. Let me graphically bring up, Abhishek, let me ask the question before your hand goes up. Let me just ask my question. Come on. I heard you patiently. Now just hear my question. Here's the email. Okay, the email signed off at the end says, "Cheers, Robert." This is an email from the 4th of April 2010 in response to an email from Sumit Chadda, an associate of Sanjay Bhandari, who's asking Robert Vadra to reimburse him for the expenses that have been sort of the money that's been spent to refurbish and renovate the London property that's at the heart of this entire dispute. And Robert Vadra writes back saying, "Did not know the money had not reached you. We'll sort it out and we'll ask Manoj to be in touch." Subsequently, his assistant, according to this probe report, I'm quoting from the probe report. The probe report says, subsequently, Mr. Vadra's assistant was the one who kept in touch using this particular email called Exim Real Estate. Further, Sanjay Bhandari was questioned by tax officials and, according to this probe report, did not deny that when this property was sold, Mr. Vadra may have been a beneficiary. Now, Abhishek, I'm not an investigator, but I'm quoting from a probe report that our team of reporters has seen. And it quotes this email, and Mr. Vadra has not categorically denied this email.
You're making my point, Barkha.
He's not denied this email.
You have made the exact point. I'm grateful. Just take what you said in the last 2 minutes to me.
Yes.
This is a probe of the Finance Ministry, Finance Ministry controlled Income Tax Department and other agencies, right?
Yes.
In this probe, which is probably 1, 2, 3 months old, you are quoting emails from A to B, from Vadra to others and from others to Vadra.
Yeah.
In this probe, you are extrapolating that therefore there is a Benami holding by Vadra through Sanjay Bhandari, right?
I'm saying that's
Would you have a single notice? One sec, Barkha. What kind of probe is this that for 3 months you are investigating internally, not one show cause notice to Vadra?
Suppose you want to send me a show cause. Bhandari was raided last month. Bhandari was raided last month.
Let me complete. Barkha, let me complete.
Yes.
You don't ask Vadra to explain a single mail.
Yes.
He could have 20 explanations for writing this, just like Mr. Siddharthnath Singh can have 20 explanations for the 164 calls.
Okay.
But before he can explain, before he has even got a notice in 30 days.
Yes.
A story is leaked, I don't mean you, but it is leaked to the press. Why does the probe report and the Finance Ministry report gets leaked to the press before Vadra gets a single notice?
But that's a journalist's prerogative is to dig out documents that are not meant to come out officially. That is a journalist's prerogative.
One minute.
And that is our job, by the way.
Look. Barkha, a journalist's prerogative I understand very well. Selective leaks by government departments to people is a different matter. Now, suppose you had sent this, what you have got.
Yes.
To Vadra.
Yes.
Vadra would have given a reply.
I did.
Then it wouldn't be news.
Abhishek, I wrote to him six days ago. I got no reply.
Barkha, you are missing the point. Barkha, you are missing the point.
Okay.
In 1 month, if the ED or the IT had written one two-line letter to Vadra,
okay.
He would have replied repudiating.
Okay, can
and
I
then
now
there'd
open
be no
this
program,
the pattern,
there'd
we'll
be no
very
value.
Okay.
The
okay.
government wants to sensationalize.
Sambit Patra.
They don't want a closure.
Abhishek, now you've had a long say. I must allow the others to come in. Abhishek has made the point, Sambit, that there is a certain deliberate pattern to this, that they must defend Robert Vadra because Robert Vadra has become a proxy tool of the BJP to attack Sonia Gandhi. Sambit.
So if Robert Vadra is a trap that we are laying for the Congress to fall into, why are they time and again falling into the trap? And look, supposedly what Mr. Abhishek Manu Singhvi is saying is true. Supposedly the government has laid a trap by leakages. Then the government, then the Congress party has fallen into the trap. Leap aside the Congress party, Sonia Gandhi has jumped into the trap. Otherwise, unfazed Abhishek Manu Singhvi, who is such an erudite speaker, who would not shout any time in his debate today, has been saying, shouting on your debate. This means all is not well in the Congress. Mr. Abhishek Manu Singhvi says that there is nothing in this case. If there would have been nothing in this case, Mr. Abhishek Manu Singhvi, Mr. Abhishek Manu Singhvi and Mrs. Sonia Gandhi would not have been in the forefront defending Mr. Robert Vadra. That there is something that you all are trying to defend Mr. Vadra.
But
now come to the specific
fair point of why, of how the, it may suit the BJP politically to have noise rather than resolution. That even in the land deals, actually, eventually nothing happened. You know, in the campaign, you all coined the phrase Damadji. Ravi Shankar Prasad said he can be jailed for corruption. None of that happened, Sambit. So there's a sense that you prefer the noise to a resolution.
That. Let me answer this categorically. Yes. This is the characteristic feature of the Congress party. When you allege something against the Gandhi family, then the first teaser that the Congress throws at you is, if you have evidences, why don't you move the court? If you have evidences, why don't you investigate against us? And if you move to the court and then the court punishes them, and if you move to the investigative agencies and the investigative agencies find out the truth and the ball lies in your court, then they start crying vendetta politics. They say, ye badle ki rajniti hai. Then they stall the parliament. Remember, in the National Herald case, the day an observation was pronounced by the High Court, leave aside Bharatiya Janata Party. The High Court said that there was criminal conspiracy, accused number one being Sonia Gandhi and accused number two being Rahul Gandhi. Both of them are out on bail. They stalled the parliament the next day and they said this is badle ki rajniti, this is vendetta politics.
So let me get
way, when the Congress party is the Congress party is caught, they cry foul.
Pawan Verma, which way does the JD you lean on this? You share a you share a government with the Congress in Bihar, but the point is that do you really want to take on the Congress's battle to defend Robert Vadra? Do you want to really convert what is most likely their political liability into your own as well?
No, I want to make three or four points, Barkha.
Yes.
Firstly, Mr. Robert Vadra is a private citizen.
How is he a private citizen when the Congress president is defending him? When the Congress president is defending him, he's no longer a private citizen.
I said I'll make 4 points. Yes. You cut me short at first. I was going to answer your question.
Okay.
So he should defend himself. But I do believe that if he is to defend himself, there should be at least a notice sent to him from the IT department and the enforcement directorate, which is otherwise very active when the BJP wants.
Okay.
But no notice has been sent to him. So apart from the letter from his lawyer, we don't know his defense, but that is his business.
Yes.
I saw the footage, Barkha, of the NDTV interaction with Mrs. Sonia Gandhi.
Yes.
What I can say is that what she said was that let the matter be probed or doodh ka doodh or pani ka pani ho jaye.
Yes.
In other words, she said, if there is any truth in this allegation, let's get down to the facts of it and then the consequences under law should follow.
Yes.
What I fear, and this is my third point and I'll finish in 30 seconds. What I fear is that there is a carefully planned smear campaign against opposition leaders through the use of half-baked innuendos, premature allegations and selective leaks which are happening on a regular basis rather than allowing the due process of law to take place.
Okay.
This is a serious matter.
Okay.
And I believe this is a political ploy along with the use later of the Ram Mandir issue. The last point I want to make is this zeal with regard to Mr. Vadra or anyone related to the Congress leadership. I say to the other cases, has any BJP leader said that let there be a fair probe in the Lalit Modi case, in the Vyapam case, in the Chhattisgarh scam case, in the Gujarat land scam case?
Okay, I'll get Sambit. Okay,
Barkha, all of them have got more time than me. Let me respond.
Yeah, can we please cut to Sambit? Sambit, go ahead.
Number one, both Mr. Abhishek Panu Singhvi as well as Pawan Verma have spoken about the fact that, well, we may be having leakages, but where are the notices? And I challenge you and I tell you, Barkha, if tomorrow there is a notice issued to Robert Vadra, then the same people would be crying and saying that, look, this is vendetta politics. How dare you issue a notice to Robert Vadra? He's such a wonderful person.
No, so are you saying that?
I tell you, just wait for the notice.
But Sonia Gandhi...
Who is saying that...
See, but Barkha, don't do selective leaks. Issue a notice. Yes, here is reply.
Pawan, don't shout at me. Pawan,
yeah,
I was not interjecting
and
you were speaking. Allow me to complete.
I'm not shouting at you.
All I wanted to say...
I don't know why you think everyone is shouting
Pawan.
At you.
Okay, come on, guys, let's move.
No, Pawan. We know you are all disturbed because
I think it's fair to say that if the government believes it has a solid set of leads, it must follow it up logically with a notice. That's the process. Now, I want to just get Tabligh.
Barkha, let me complete on this.
Sambit,
you have asked a number of things about this notice. Let me complete about this notice.
Complete your point and I really must go to the others.
Yes. Yes, I understand that. Look, as far as the notice is concerned, you yourself have been saying that through your sources you have got to know that this investigation is on.
Yes.
So investigation is on means the notice may follow. So why do you conclude that there would be no notice and that the...
I'm not concluding. I'm saying that the Congress and the JDU is saying
the Congress and the JDU, why are they concluding that there would be no notice?
Okay, can I get more
if there's an investigation on, please wait patiently for the notice.
May I ask the politicians to just hold on for just one moment? Tavleen, you have said on Twitter that this could be another Quathroki moment. What did you mean? But you also had a warning. Will it go to its logical conclusion? And that's really, in a sense, what a lot number of people have been saying, that is this all going to be a lot of sound and fury signifying nothing, or will it amount to something? Will this probe go to its logical next step?
Okay, I'll answer that. But first, I'm really surprised at how patient you've been while they've rubbished your story. They're talking about selective leaks. It's your story, isn't it?
NDTV
broke a story.
Of course it's our story, and we're very proud of this story. But you know,
Tavleen,
I'm used to them insinuating motives, so I just ignore it. I'm used to politicians insinuating motives, and I ignore
that. It's a selective leak.
Yeah.
So, you know, I mean, what is this nonsense? It's a story that you did, which has been picked up by the other channels, because it was a good story.
Yeah.
Right?
Yes.
Secondly, as we know, in the case of Robert Vadra, it's easier to believe that he was up to no good than that he was, you know, doodh ka dhula, okay? Thirdly, when Sonia Gandhi, you know, responded with such ire this morning, before she said doodh ka doodh and pani ka pani ho jayega, she also said this is part of a campaign to make it Congress mukt Bharat.
Yes.
So is now Robert Vadra the Congress party?
Yeah,
right?
That's the key point.
Now let me explain why
Now,
let me explain why I used the Quathroki connection.
Yeah.
Quathroki, the trail led right up to Sonia Gandhi, because the bank accounts in which the bribe money was found was of her best friends. Mm. Now, Mr. Quathroki was a fertilizer salesman. No arms company would be giving a fertilizer salesman a bribe unless he did something for them, right? Mm. Now, in this case, we know, you and I know, and whether they can actually, you know, trace it or not, because these are shell companies that are very hard to trace.
Yeah.
We know that our politicians have land and flats abroad.
Yeah.
And, you know, since Mr. Vadra has been very much in the real estate business, why would he not have a flat abroad, you know, like he's had in Gurgaon?
Yeah.
So, you know, the point is, what's very interesting is that the Congress party now believes that this is a plot to defame the Congress party, which means he must become a member of the Congress party, or he has become already the Congress party.
That is exactly the point. And as for Tavleen, my patience with politicians who accuse us of being, you know, beneficiaries of selective leaks, I tend to sort of tune out the rhetoric of politicians. We have said since yesterday, we proudly stand by this story. And it is, as I said to Abhishek, our journalistic prerogative and our rigor to chase a lead. That's what journalists do. It is our job to get out documents that are not yet official, and that is what we have done with this story. Mohandas Pai.
You did a good story.
Thank you, Tavleen. Mohandas Pai, the political implications of what Sonia Gandhi said today. From you and KTS, and Abhishek, I'm coming back to you after that. Mohandas, go ahead.
No, I think all this raises a very big point, Barkha, and that is, What do relatives of political leaders do when they come close to power?
Yes.
I think throughout the last 20, 30 years, and we see it in many states now, you know, family parties have grown, family members have come together, and there's no denying that family members exercise influence on the political leader. It's happened in almost all political parties.
Yeah.
And here there was a denial that Mr. Vadra was not part of the political family, but now I think with this defense, is becoming clear. But the important thing, Barkha, which we all citizens want to know is, what happens to all the probes, all this kind of debate, all this kind of noise? Does it lead to a conviction? Why does it always peter out?
Yes.
How many have been closed in the last 20, 30 years?
Yes.
How many are still going on?
Yes.
Even the Bofors issue, we had no resolution ultimately.
Yes.
For all the scandals in defense, we have had no resolution.
Yes.
It keeps going on, and that means there's a Malaysia, India lacks investigative ability. It lacks prosecutors who can take it to court and close it.
Yeah.
It lacks judges and courts which can close it up.
Yes.
Like Lalu's, you know, that Lalu scandal about all that matter. I think it's still going on and on for 20 years. To me, that is a bigger issue. And that is a bigger issue which you need to address, and this is one small part of the big drama.
But KTS Tulsi, I think Tavleen Singh has a very sharp question. As somebody who's defended Mr. Vadra before in his, on his land deals, would you say that Robert Vadra is now the Congress party, that you can no longer say he's a private citizen who must defend himself? Because it is the entire Congress leadership from the president downwards who's on TV to defend himself after our exclusive report, Mr. Tulsi.
Well, that's a political question that Abhishek is, will deal. Mm. What I want to say is that NDTV itself, which accessed the emails,
yes,
has categorically said, according to the media reports, that it cannot confirm the authenticity of these emails.
Mm.
So the most tenuous link with Robert Vadra becomes is rendered worthless.
Not at all.
As of today,
I will interject here, Mr. Tulsi, because
it is rendered,
quote from a probe report. This is the probe report of the Government of India, of the Finance Ministry. The probe report quotes this particular email. It gives a date and a year. I specifically wrote to Mr. Vadra's lawyers, Sumit Khetan, who sent us a legal notice yesterday, by the way. I copied and pasted this email and I said, do you deny that your client wrote this mail? I never got an answer. Of course, technically, we are not sitting in Mr. Vadra's computer. We have quoted from a Government of India probe report. So we can't say who's written this email. But Mr. Vadra's lawyer, when asked, is this email true, has chosen to remain silent, Mr. Tulsi.
No, you can't take contradictory stands.
It's not a contradictory
You have said
stand.
In writing that you cannot vouch for the authenticity.
Because it's the Government of India report.
You cannot confirm the authenticity.
Let Mr. Vadra come out and deny that this is his email.
If you cannot,
Let Mr. Vadra deny that it's his email.
I consider all this. And what does the email say? That can anyone use, and anybody can use anybody's name. The question is, if
so
you
let Mr. Vadra deny these
the
emails.
Authenticity, you can't build a story
sir,
on it.
So in that case,
if
sir,
you cannot
sir,
confirm
that's a very
the authenticity,
simple, sir, I'll give you a very
you
simple
cannot
way.
Build a story on
sir,
it.
Do you know that Mr. Vadra had 6 days from us to deny this email? He chose not to respond at all. Yesterday, when we got a letter from his lawyers denying the allegations finally, and then threatening us with legal action if we went ahead, I wrote to this lawyer and I said, here's the email. Do you deny this email? And he did not deny the email. He was silent. Why doesn't Robert Vadra just come ahead
why
and come
he?
Out and say, why should he not? If he's not written the email and the Government
but
of India has fabricated
he?
It. If Government of India has fabricated
No, you're not
email,
holding a trial. This is not a media trial.
Okay, but
and
then...
Why should
why
he open
should
his
the IT Department
the question,
or Enforcement Directorate
really
send a notice?
No, the question is...
Yes.
Can I ask you one question?
Mr. Tulsi,
I want to know
my
whether Sanjay Bhandari was given.
Yes, Sanjay Bhandari.
No, I want to know whether Sanjay Bhandari was given a deal to supply parts for 38 combat aircraft in 2014 after Modi government came in. Now, if that is true, is he not being used? Is he not being used?
By
and
whom?
Siddharth Nath Singh's connection becomes significant.
Siddharth is coming up
this,
on this program
this
in a
This becomes
moment.
A conspiracy.
What's the conspiracy?
It does become a conspiracy.
You're saying Bhandari is being
on the
used?
Basis
You're
of,
saying Bhandari is being used?
On the basis of emails?
You're saying Bhandari is being used by the government against
yes?
Vadra? Okay, Abhishek Singh, we come in on that. Come in on that. You see, the thing is, you know as a lawyer, both of you are lawyers.
I have
why doesn't Mr. Vadra just simply say, I did not write this email? He hasn't said that.
Barkha, I just... Permit me to give my 4 or 5 points very quickly.
Yes.
I have heard the entire panel.
Yes.
First and foremost, I find this a ridiculous semantic issue that why is the Congress party speaking in favor of Vadra?
Yeah.
When, for example, the son-in-law of a former very respected prime minister is attacked,
yes.
The BJP must have 20,000 times given clarifications.
Mm.
At that time, the question doesn't arise.
Mm.
You use the Vadra stick to beat the Congress party, the Congress president, the Congress vice president daily. The Congress should keep quiet. This is a very nice semantic lesson I've learned from a journalist on your panel. The second lesson I've learned from the journalist on the panel is
yes.
that you will have, because we know that Indian politicians keep a lot of money stashed abroad, Vadra must have kept it abroad, and it is natural to presume that Vadra must have a house, and that house must be naturally a Benami house.
Yes.
If that is the basis on